people see me in the world and they ask me, dude, what book should I read? I said to them, well, that depends on what you want to learn. But books are very good for learning things. They say about the way that you cannot write it down, yet men do. They say that writings will not help you achieve the knowledge within yourself, yet people go there for that knowledge to learn it within themselves. Sometimes people will not automatically draw the same wisdom from the universe that others have drawn themselves. They will not automatically observe the things around them and come to analytical conclusions which will produce rational, logical expressions of symbolic patterns within the world around them, which can be re-expressed and re-expressed and re-expressed. Some people just cannot put things into mathematical terms which are constant and absolute. That is a condition amongst human beings which is not a problem. Other people have found a way. They have found a way to express the way. And although it is not perfect and it is not absolute and it is not complete or comprehensive, it leads people to that. Now, if you are looking for spiritual wisdom through books, I have very many suggestions for you, but I will start with the best. And the very best is the book that is known as the Lao Tzu. It's known as the Lao Tzu in China, but in America, in English, we call this book the Tao Te Ching. Sometimes it is called The Way or The Way and Its Power. Other times it is called The Way of Life or something like that. Anyways, it is known as the Tao, and it is the best book ever written for knowing spiritual wisdom in this universe. 81 verses of poetry. You can read it in an hour and a half if you have never read it before, but you can ponder one verse for an entire lifetime and never understand it. That is how the way works, and that is why the book is such a beautiful expression of it. I recommend reading as many English translations as you can, because you as a person can, if you are an English speaking person like me, you probably cannot read Chinese and you will not understand it in its native tongue, its native forms, its native characters. That's fine. You read it in English as many times as you possibly can. See how many people have translated it in different ways, and then between all of them, you will find the truth. You will find it. You will find it there, creeping between the different translations of itself. That is why the way in English is known better sometimes than it can be by its Chinese characters. Because in Chinese, you do not have the dynamic experience of translation, which alters it and yet distills it down to its essential form. Sorry to break into chemistry on you there. Now we're going to talk about another group of books which are very important to any spiritual seeker. They are known as the Gospels, and if you consider yourself a Christian and you believe that the teachings which are available to you in the New Testament and the Old Testament, as you call them, are the best, you are mistaken. The four Gospels are what you need to know. If you call yourself a follower of the way, if you call yourself a follower of the teachings of Yeshua ben Yosef, if you call yourself a follower of the teachings of the one they call Jesus, the one many of you call Christ, you must learn the teachings from his own mouth. The teachings that come to you through Peter and Paul and James and John are not as good as the ones which are in red type and come straight from the mouth of the Son of Man, as he calls himself so often. As other people call him, that is the Son of God, and that is what they recognize in him, and that is why you must learn about this one, because he is the nexus between these two things. He is the crux of Descartes' Cartesian plane. He is the center of the Gnostic cross. He is the integration of the vertical and the horizontal horizons. He is literally the divine spark that has exploded into humankind and shown you what you are capable of and what you are not capable of, and what you should do and what you should not do. And his teachings 2,000 years ago are just as good today as they were then. There is nothing in the Bible for you who call yourself Christians. There is nothing there for you in the New Testament or the Old Testament outside of Acts 2 Revelations, or in what is known as the Tanakh for Hebrews. That is a Hebrew book, and it is for Hebrew people. It is not for Christians. The information contained within the Gospels is what you must focus on the most. And if you focus on Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, and you want more, then you need to read Thomas. Thomas is the best book. It is the second best book on the planet. It is the second book which explains things the most to people. But normal Christians are going to start with Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John first. Thomas comes second. Then you can read some of the other Gospels in the Nag Hammadi library. Oh, I'm pointing to the I Ching. Don't read that because it's a book about secrets. You don't need it. After you read the Gospels and you read the Tao Te Ching, you can read the Bhagavad Gita and the Dhammapada, and those books will help you an enormous amount to learn the nature of reality. Everything in this world that is spiritual and religious does not deal with the ultimate awareness of something you call a God. It is not a God which matters, it is what happens after death which matters most. That is where humans began to understand things first. They did not formulate ideas about a God as soon as they tried to realize what was going to happen to them after they passed into the next life. It is birth and death which are equals, and that is which you must know. You must understand the teachings of reincarnation. That is what Jesus was teaching people in the four Gospels, and that is clear if you are reading them correctly. Thank you very much for listening.